Welcome to the online class, an introduction to the NIH Biowulf cluster. This is a self-paced class, and the general process is that you watch a video about some aspect of the system and then work through some hands-on exercises to increase your familiarity. This class is recommended both for new users of the system as well as those who are already familiar with using the cluster and just want to brush up on specific aspects of using it. First of all, what is Biowulf? Biowulf is part of the National Institutes of Health High Performance Computing Core Facility. It's a central scientific compute resource managed by the NIH HPC staff in the Center for Information Technology. It's funded by the NIH Capital Investment Fund, which means it's available to all NIH intramural scientists. It's a production facility. We maintain high availability and typically have two or three downtimes per year, which lasts for 12 hours or so. There's high data durability, which means that your data resides on high-performance file systems, which are highly redundant. And the chance of data loss is very low. It's a large-scale system. At present, in June 2018, it contains over 94,000 processor cores and 25 petabytes of storage capacity. The goal of Biowulf is to enable research that's not otherwise possible. As you all know, desktops and lab systems are becoming more and more powerful, and there's a large amount of computing that can be completed on those systems. Biowulf is intended for applications that cannot be run on a typical desktop or lab system, which means usually anything large scale. It's a general purpose scientific computing system. Unlike some supercomputers, it's not dedicated to any one application type, but is intended to support all the different kinds of applications that are run on the NIH intramural campus. So that would include genomics, image analysis, computational chemistry, mathematics and statistics, and deep learning. And lastly, we ask that users who write papers that are significantly based on Biowulf usage cite Biowulf in the acknowledgements. And in 2016, there were over 380 papers based on Biowulf usage. The NIH HPC core facility includes more additional systems beyond Biowulf. It includes Helix, a single system with 128 CPUs and 1 terabyte of memory at present, which is intended for interactive data transfer. There's Felix, which is a Helix-like system, which is restricted to National Institute of Mental Health users. Helix Web is a system that runs some web applications, some developed by the NIH HPC staff and some developed outside and mirrored on our systems. SciWare is a system which allows you to run applications on your desktop. The applications and the license reside on the NIH HPC systems, but they will be actually running on your desktop and can access data on your desktop. The largest part of the HPC resources by far is the Biowulf cluster, and that provides high-performance computing and is intended for most computational jobs. Biowulf runs the Linux operating system. As of June 2018, that's Red Hat Enterprise Linux or CentOS version 7. Every single one of the top 500 supercomputers in the world run Linux. And as you can see from this chart, back in 2000, there was a relatively small percentage of them running Linux, but that percentage has increased. And as of 2017, every single one of them is a Linux system. This means that if you're using Biowulf and then you leave NIH and go to some other institution where you're also using high-performance computing, there's a good chance you'll need to use Linux again. So if you're not familiar with Linux, we highly recommend that you gain some familiarity. There are online tutorials. We teach occasional classes on Linux. And you can also, of course, buy a book and work your way through it. It will be very hard for any user to efficiently use Biowulf without having some Linux familiarity. As of November 2017, we're very proud that Biowulf is number 66 on the top 500 list of supercomputers in the world. And it's likely that it's the largest supercomputer that's entirely devoted to biomedical applications. What kind of applications are suitable for Biowulf? Here are some examples that may help you determine whether your particular use of Biowulf is appropriate for the system. If you have large numbers of jobs, such as bioinformatics on thousands of sequences, or large memory jobs, where each job requires a huge amount of computer memory, such as whole genome assemblies. If you have parallel jobs with high CPU demands, such as molecular dynamics, which run large parallel jobs across many nodes, or if you have terabytes of data to process. In other words, anything large scale. This doesn't mean that you cannot run smaller scale jobs on Biowulf. It's just that there's some overhead to using the system, to writing batch jobs and learning how to use the batch system. And for small numbers of jobs, this may not be worth it for you. What kind of jobs are unsuitable for Biowulf? If you have very small numbers of jobs, or one dependent job after another, where the input to one job is the output of the previous job, so that at any time only one job can be running. If you have interactive jobs, or jobs that use lots of graphics, there's a limit to the number of interactive jobs, and they're typically not very efficient. And graphics applications can also be pretty slow because they're running over the network from a Biowulf compute node through the Biowulf login node through the NIH network to display on your desktop system. So those are some examples where a desktop system might be more suitable. And lastly, I'm going to talk about the Biowulf website and where to go for more information. The Biowulf website is also the same as the NIH High Performance Computing website, and it's hpc.nih.gov. And that brings you to this front page about Biowulf and the other HPC systems. This website contains all the information that's covered in this course and more. It's a fairly dense website. It contains a ton of information. So I'm going to point out a few features that may be useful to you. So on the front page, on the bottom left, is a section of announcements, and that contains all the announcements that are emailed out to HPC users. So you can also come here to check on the most recent announcements. And the section on the right contains recent papers that used Biowulf and HPC resources. If you click on the All Publications link, that brings you to a page which lists every paper that's ever cited Biowulf. At present, that's well over 2,000 as of June 2018. So if you want to see what your fellow Biowulf users have been working on, then this is the place to go. On each page of the site, the drop-down menus at the top take you to various aspects of the system. And I'm going to talk about the application section now. If you notice, the Applications drop-down menu contains a list of different research areas. So let's just click on Applications. And that brings you to the Biowulf Applications page. And on the top, you see it contains the same research areas. So under each section is a list of applications that we have centrally installed on the cluster. That means they're installed, maintained, and updated, and documented by the HPC staff. Each of these applications is a link. And if you click on that link, it takes you to a web page which is specifically about that application on Biowulf. As you notice, there's only a brief description of the application itself. Most of These pages are not intended to teach you about the application or to advise you on whether one application is more suitable than another for your scientific purpose. These pages are intended to teach you to how to run the application on Biowulf. So typically they contain a batch script, and for some applications there may be a sample interactive session, how to run the application interactively, and a sample command to submit the batch script. Depending on the application, there may be additional information like how to run it on a GPU, and that depends on the type of application that's being described here. So once you've worked your way through this online course, then the first thing you probably want to do is go to the application section and look up the web pages for the applications of your interest. There are typically some sample data, and there will be some examples of how to submit a job. So before you submit jobs with your own data, you probably want to submit a test job with the sample data. Going back to the applications page, you see it's extremely long. It contains about 500 different applications. In addition to the applications that are centrally installed, each user is also welcome to install applications in their own space on Biowulf. In some cases, that may be difficult. For example, you may not know where the required libraries are, or there may be other aspects of installing it that you're not familiar with. In that case, you're welcome to email the HPC staff and ask for the application to be installed. There's also a menu item for reference data. And this contains links to centrally installed databases on our system. Before you download a large amount of reference data, we highly recommend that you come here and check our existing list to see whether it's already centrally maintained on the system, so that you don't copy it down to your own space again and thus duplicate data on our system. So for example, there's a large amount of BLAST databases which are updated weekly, and this tells you the location as well as when they were last updated. There are databases for very specific purposes, such as HiSat indexes or PlinkSeq data, and other databases that are required by specific applications. So again, before you download data, this is the best place to check for whether it's already installed on the system. And lastly, there's a user guide section. And the top entry here is the Biowulf user guide, and that takes you to a web page which contains all the information that's covered in this course and more, in more detail, with more samples commands. So we may update these pages frequently. If anything changes on the system, the website reflects the changes. So we recommend that you come here every now and then and check if anything has changed since you last used a particular command. The user guide section also contains some more specific user guides, such as how to run Singularity containers or Jupyter notebooks, and a section about training and training videos, which includes this one. Thank you.